Good afternoon, YouTube. It is Monday. It is the 12th of March. God, where's the year going? Ridiculous. Yes, I look like crap. I will have a shave. What we're doing today is going to be my peas. Quite a few to go through, actually, so we'll get straight into that. I have six pickups that arrived in the post this morning, so we'll show you those quick. I'll just give you another reminder about this week's competition because it's bigger than last week's. Then we'll get straight into the peas, and I hope you all had a good weekend. A few obscure ones this time. First one that came was Dead Space Downfall. I like the look of this. I haven't really got much manga, so you know, I wanted to beef that up a bit. American Mary. I thought it was a horror, so I'm not too sure. Let me know if you think it's a good film. Blue Crush 2. Now, the first one I think has got Paul Walker in, I think. But I can't find that anywhere, so I will hunt him down at some point. Then, Live from Space. This is a series, I think, that the BBC did, where they were talking to the International Space Station. That's like the visuals, really. Saw the advert for this, a film called Nerve. I think it looks quite cool, actually, so we're probably going to be watching this tonight, so I'll let you know what I think. And I've been waiting a couple of weeks for this. The Steelbook. For The Last Witch Hunter. I've got it original, so now I've got it steelbook as well. Got a double fronted look to it, really. But I quite enjoyed that film. I thought that was quite cool. So that's my six pickups. Yeah, and yes, I still do have more due. Annoyingly. Right, quite a few people are entering these competitions, so I'm glad of that. But Friday at 9 p.m. is the closing date, so remember, Kick-Ass 1 and 2 is one prize. And Despicable Me 1 and 2 is the second prize. So get your names down. Remember, you got to subscribe. Then you got to knock me on Facebook. And it's Blu-ray space Bullet Brit. And then send me a message there. We'll click as friends. Message me and you will be entered. Okay? That's brilliant. Bit tired today. I didn't really sleep too well last night. Let's get straight into these peas, get them sorted out, so hopefully the video won't be too long. I'll do my best. I'll probably do my best not to drop them again because there's quite a few here. Here we go. Gotta keep looking at the camera. I'm starting to look at there again. Here we go. Firstly, brilliant film. Can't wait for the sequel, Pacific Rim. I'd have loved it. So of course I've got to get it in 3D, haven't I? I haven't watched the 3D version yet. Definitely gonna though. Move these up so they don't all fall off. Then we have Pact. That looked like quite a decent film, really. I saw the advert ages ago for this, but I still yet to watch it. But as you know, horror is my weakest genre, so I need to buff him up. Paddington. Now, Paddington 2 came out today. I'm not gonna pay full price for that. I mean, I like the look of the steelbook, but I'm not paying 22 quid for a Paddington. It will be something I pick up, of course, because I do like it. Pain and Gain. Brilliant film. Yet again, Mark Wahlberg, so the missus is happy. Then we have Pandorum. This looks cheap. I recommend it. It's basically zombies in a space station. This is some weird stuff, this is. But I think that's well worth a watch. Imagine coming out as stasis and being chomped on by a zombie literally as you wake up. It's freaky stuff. Panic Button. Heard good things, but I still would watch it. Based in a plane, so a bit weird. Then we have Pan's Labyrinth. I've waited so long to own this, I still haven't watched it. Del Toro just won the Oscar for that mute lady falling in love with a creature that lives in water. I can't remember what it was called now, but he just won that, so well done to him. Paper Towns. It was cheap. I've heard good things, but yet to watch it. We'll get around to it. Now we have Paranormal Activity 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, or basically the Ghost Dimension, 6, the Mark ones. I haven't watched any of them. I just haven't yet. My missus hates shaky cam films. It makes her sick. She really, really hates them. So it's one of those I'm going to have to watch when she's not around. Blu-ray and 3D version of Paranorman. I quite enjoyed that. Then we have Parental Guidance. I love Billy Crystal, but I just haven't watched this yet. It's one of those afternoon films, I think. I just ain't got around to it. Parker, Jason Statham, enough said. Gotta love Statham. Passion Dow. It's me trying to get more of these war films under my belt. Have yet to watch it, though. Passengers. I want to get the 3D version of this because I quite enjoyed this. Hardly an acting masterclass by Chris Pratt, but I think it's worthy. Some good visuals, definitely. And another film called Passengers that's totally different. Anne Hathaway, I always like her, but supposedly a decent thriller, still yet to watch it. You might hear a plane go over in a minute, because unfortunately I do live near an airport. Now if I can get the second pipe without dropping it, that would be brilliant. There we go. Oh, sorry about that. There we go. Sorry, the picture's a bit dark as well. It's just too bright today. Passion of the Christ. That's brutal. Really is. Then we have Patagonia 3D, another one of those nature ones. You know, I love those. Then we got Pathology, cheap horror, very, very cheap. Haven't watched it yet. Patriot, one of Mel Gibson's best. Love it. I think, is Heath Ledger in this? I think he is, isn't he? Let's have a look. Yeah, he is. He plays his son. Yeah, he was good in that. Then we have one of my favourite films ever, my competition prize of last week, Paul. Love that film. I love this. Paul Blart Mall Cop. It's a simple, fun. But then they went and did that, which is every single joke exactly the bloody same, just somewhere else. What? That's a load of crap. First one's brilliant. Then we have Pay the Ghost. Nicolas Cage still paying the bills. Payback Season. I think this is one of those British films, hooligan films again. Still haven't watched it. Pearl Harbor. Could have been a lot better. Tries to be epic when the substance wasn't there, really. Worth a watch, I'd say, but not my best film. The Pelican Brief. Anything with Denzel Washington, I'll watch. Julie Roberts, not so much, but still yet to watch this, but I'm well aware of its reputation, so that's why I got it. Penguins of Madagascar. They're classics, you know they are. I only picked this one up recently, but I mean, if you're my age, basically old, you know this is a brilliant film, so classic. Percy Jackson and the Lightning Thief. Now, I enjoyed this. It was a bit cheapy on the old effects, but yeah, I really enjoyed that actually. But I have yet to see the sequel, Sea of Monsters. I'm not sure if one or both of those is available 3D. But I'll have to rummage around and see if I can pick them up. Perfect Getaway. Another cheap thriller. Haven't seen it yet. Perfect Storm. Another Mark Wahlberg. And this is all like this. Maybe if we ever get around to watching it. It's got George Clooney as well. So, you know, what can be said about that? Another recent pickup. The Perks of Being a Wallflower. Heard good things. Still yet to watch it. Then we got Perrier's Bounty. It was cheap. I like Brendan Gleeson in it as well. So there's a couple of some good British actors in there. But yet to see it yet again. Then we have Pet. This is available in Palmworld. It's a horror, thrillery type thing. Still haven't watched it. Then we have Phantom. To do with, I think, the curse going down, actually. But it's got the David Duchovny, so he's paying the bills, I think. Then we have Philly Kid. I like boxing films or action fighting, stuff like that, so might be cheap looking, but I think that's worth a 50p dangle, won't it? Philomena. Now, end of the day, yeah, Judi Dench, one of our best actresses ever. You got to watch this. Not the biggest fan of Steve Coogan. I do have a couple of his films. If any of you Americans are wondering who Steve Coogan is, the Roman guy, midget, you know, diorama out of Night of the Museum. It's him. And then Phone Booth. Awesome film. You think, what the hell are they going to do with a phone booth? Watch this, seriously. Colin Farrell's brilliant in it. Right. Just make sure I get the right one. There's five piles all together, by the way. Next, picture perfect. Calibrate your TV, people. Get this disc. There's a HD version, there's a 4K version now, which actually has a USB stick with it. It's worth it. Don't pay 124 quid for some other mug, come do it for you. Get it. Then we have Pimp, another Danny Dyer. So I will collect most things that are Danny Dyer just because I love him, he's brilliant. Pineapple Express. Everyone knows the reputation of this film, but I still haven't seen it. But I love James Franco, he's an idiot. Then we have the Pink Panther remake. And then we have the sequel to the Pink Panther remake. So I think those are simply Steve Martin paying the bills. Not that good. Piranha 3D. I want to get the original, but it's I know it's out in America, but I don't think it's out here. Then we have Piranha 3DD. Yeah, that's the way to name a sequel, guys, isn't it? Ooh, what am I doing? Then we have the absolute classic, awesome, brilliant, brilliant, brilliant Pirates of the Caribbean. Then we have Dead Man's Chest. I enjoyed that. There was too much shine in this room today. There you go. Then we have At World's End. Then we have On Stranger Tides. I think they were pushing it a bit with this. It was all, that was okay. But then we have On Stranger Tides 3D as well. I had to get that. 3D is quite good on there, but I think it shows up the cheapness of the production when you watch it in 3D, I really do. And then we have the 3D version of Salazar's Revenge as well. That really shows that they're struggling, if you ask my, in my opinion now. Quite why they were doing other ones beyond me. Now, here we go. The Pirates in an Adventure with Scientists. Stop Animation, Aardman Animation, you know it's brilliant. Of course, I had to have it in 3D as well, didn't I? Next, we have Pitch Black with Vin Diesel Steelbook. Nah, I do like that. This, if you've got an OLED TV, this is the film to watch because it's so dark, it knocks your socks off. It's brilliant. Next, we have Pitch Perfect. Haven't watched it yet, but yeah, they got a good amount of momentum behind them, so that's why I picked up the sequel as well. And a couple of those birds in that are nuts. Third one's going to be out soon. I think it's within the next couple of months. Pitch Perfect 3 is out, so we'll have to look out for that. One of my favourite films, Adam Sandler, brilliant. I love this. Pixels. It's funny. It's nostalgic. Got to get it. And if you really like it, you've got to get it in 3D. Because it's really, really good in 3D. But who stops there? Not me. Yeah, I'll get it in Steelbook as well. Look at that. Brilliant. How can you not have it? Place Beyond the Pines. Place Beyond the Pines. Heard good things, yet to watch. Disney Planes. Not going to not pick up Disney, am I? Then we have, of course, in 3D as well. Real colourful film, that. Picked up the sequel. I haven't watched him yet. Planes, Fire and Ice. And then we have Planet 51. Now, The Rock doing his voiceover. Yeah. Just about okay, I would say, on that one. Next pile's a big one, so I'll be careful. Come here, you. There you go. People are outside. Then we have Planet of the Apes. I just recently picked this up, the original classic. You've got to have that in your collection, really. Especially with all the other ape films I've got. Playing for Keeps, another one of those mushy, mushy, mushy ones. Point Blank. No idea. I heard a review of this once, and it's supposed to be quite good. Let me know if I've been duped. Point Break. What Are You Gonna Do? Absolute classic. Patrick Swayze at his best. Oh, didn't think much of this. You know. Yes, I did get it 3D as well. it's okay, but it's all stage set really tackling, if you ask me. Polar Express, Tom Hanks. I love the colours in that film. I thought it was brilliant. So, yes, indeed, I had to pick it up in 3D as well. Both of those were picked up cheap as hell in charity shops for those. So, quite impressed with that. There you go. I told you I'd draw one. Police Story Lockdown. This is, I think, the fourth or fifth film, which is a bit annoying.
Hold on.
I used to have a copy of Police Story, the original, in a gold version of the Golden Harvest clamshell case. You have no idea how rare that is. And it got stolen out of my house in a burglary like well over 20 years ago. Really annoying. But that was one of my favourite things I had. I was gutted when that got nicked. And if you haven't seen Police Story, what are you doing looking at films? If you haven't seen the original Police Story, find it. Watch it. Literally every action film in the past 25 odd years is based upon it. It's that simple. Pompeii. I think I watched him enough in Game of Thrones. But yet again, didn't stop me getting the 3D version as well. The remake of Poseidon. I want to get the original because Gene Hackman, you know, classic. Haven't watched all of this. Kurt Russell's in that, though. Then we have The Possession. Apparently based on true story. Not that I've heard of it. I do apologise for the darkness in the room. I don't know if it's just my monitor showing it dark, but I'll try my best to, if you're having any trouble seeing anything, give me a comment. Postman Pat the movie. It was 50p, what are you going to do? Power Rangers. Haven't brought myself to watch this yet. I did get it cheap. I think I will at some point. I feel a bit dirty getting that. Precious. I got this simply because that girl can act. You know? Still haven't watched it yet, but I will do. Bruce Willis. Gotta love him. Precious Cargo. Haven't heard of the film before, but it's Bruce Willis. What are you going to do? Then we have Predator. I want to pick the 3D version of this up, but I'm not paying 10 quid for a film that old. Let it come down in price secondhand, and then I'll pick him up, or if I can, as a Steelbook 3D. Then we got Predator 2. Danny Glover, that was a classic. Gary Busey was a nut job in that. But Adrian Brody, what were you thinking? Oh my god. Something seriously wrong with Predators, if you ask me. I heard good things about Predestination. Let me know if you've seen this film, because I do want to watch it at some point. But we'll see. Ethan Hawke, he's always cool. Then we have Premium Rush. I've only watched about half of this. I got interrupted. It's supposed to be a good film. This Pretty Woman. My sister's partner gave me this because I think she got it for free from one of her family and she didn't have a Blu-ray player, so she supported me. So appreciate that. No, I still got it. I haven't sold it or anything. And it's a classic film as well. Pride and Glory. What can you say? It's Colin Farrell and there's John Voight. What are you going to do? Edward Norton. You know, you can't not say you want to watch that, really, can you? Then we have Priest. I've heard good things, but I still haven't seen it. I mean, I got it cheap because it was a rental copy. But then I thought, no, I need to invest in the 3D before I actually watch this. So I will get around to it. I've heard good things. The Prince. It's Bruce Willis again. Looks like some good action, but again, this is one I haven't got around to yet. Then we have Prince of Persia. It's Jake Gyllenhaal when he finally went and got a bit of muscle on. I've seen parts of this, but I haven't seen the whole thing. It looks a bit too weird, if you ask me, but you know me, I'll still watch it. Let's have a look. Then we have Last Pile. Prisoners. Brutal film. Child abduction. Yeah, you need to have a strong will to watch that, I think. But it is Wolverine, you know. He's in it. Project Almanac. Good premise to that story. I like the adverts, so I will watch it at some point. Project X. Got it cheap, never watched it. But it's from the producers of The Hangover, so there's got to be something good about it. Prom Night, the remake. heard good things, but yeah, another one I watched, but it's a horror title, so there you go. Disappointed. Can't explain why. It's just, I think somebody just gave the guy an open check, but a sequel, and I dare you to make it. A prophet. Scarface meets the Godfather. That's a tall quote, really, but it's all right. The Proposal. Sandra Bullock and Ryan Reynolds. Now you're not going to watch it. Bit weird, bit creepy. Prowl. Cheap vampires or whatever the hell it is. But it was cheap. Then we have Public Enemies. It's Johnny Depp, so of course I'm going to watch it, but just haven't got around to it yet. Then we have, recently sent to me by a viewer, which thank you again, The Punisher Steelbook. Awesome. Awesome. I can't believe he sent me that. You're the man. You know who you are. The Purge. Quite surprised by these, actually. This one is really good. This one. Yeah. In my opinion, remember, this one. Stinking polish. Well, you know. Oof. But they're doing a prequel, aren't they? The first Purge. I have to wait and see what that one's like. The Pursuit of Happiness. Will Smith, you rock. Simple as that. Real motion in that film. I think it worked really well. I liked it. Push. Chris Evans before he was Captain America. The effects aren't good in this. The storyline's not good. The acting's not good. But 50p, I'll have it. Then we've got Pusher. I think this is British. Looks a bit cheap to me. I haven't watched it yet. And one of the best funny films. Puss in Boots. Yeah, you gotta watch this. Love it. Antonio Banderas, the perfect voice. So, you know, got it in 3D as well, didn't I? Okay. That is my peas. So that has taken 21 minutes and 52 seconds to film. So hope you like it. The Q's and the R's I think I'll do together because I've got like 9 Q's, and so I'm not going to do that in a single video. Hopefully some more of my pickups will turn up tomorrow. And for Eagle-Eyed, there's now 3 titles out there towards next week's competition. I'll give away 1 or 2 next week, but I'm still stacking up competitions as we go, so I am taking this seriously. I look like crap today, so my apologies. And I'll keep looking at the monitor because I'm looking how crap I look. I just had a crappy weekend. Be safe, everybody. Enjoy the rest of you. Well, say it's Monday, isn't it? So you're all going to be depressed. I'll get this up as soon as possible. Any comments? I've got 97 subscribers, believe it or not, now. I'm so happy. I'm still dreaming up what I'm going to do. I'm going to do a little giveaway when I reach 100 subscribers. I'll let you all know when I do, and I'll let you know what that prize is going to be at the time. But I'm still mulling over what I'm going to do, but it's going to be better than your average prize. So tell your mates, get them subscribing, and get them to enter the competition. Enjoy the rest of your day.